Hi, I'm Stuart Dunn from Universal Rocks, and I have Deborah here today to help demonstrate how easy it is to install Universal Rocks into the garden.
I'm looking forward to it.
Thanks, Deborah.
Thank you.
Okay, Deborah, the rocks that we've got in front of us today, we've got three of the garden edge rocks and we've got three of the accent rocks. What I think would be a great idea is to use some of these garden edge rocks on this slight little slope that we've got, and they're actually made for that. Hey, I'll tell you where they come from. Out west Texas, all the way near El Paso, what we do is we go out there and we'll show you some little close-ups of the molds that we get out in the bush or out in the desert, in actual fact, and we go out there and paint rubber on them. And then we spend a week out there, we peel that rubber off, and then we come back to our factory and we use the same thing, crushed rock and sands, to colour it. So we get an exact replica of the rocks wherever we go, and then, but hey, we get the lightweight factor, and it makes it easy for you and I to install these and anybody else who wants to get involved in using Universal Rocks. So.
Great.
How about we place a few and just do what we classically call put and look.
Okay, just one question.
Yep.
Will I have to remove this edging here?
I think it doesn't matter either way, because you can actually weed eat against the edge of these, so you're not going to hurt the rock. And I think that edging's already in there. That's a lot of work to pull that out. So let's just go straight over the top, backfill behind our rocks, move a few plants if we need to, or add a few more plants, and it'll be a fun little project.
Okay, great.
Well, you start with that one. Where do you think it should go? Now this is the fun part about it. It's not a 500-pound rock that you've got to get a bobcat in or a forklift in to move it. You can just do exactly what you've done. Just put it down, place it wherever you like. Keep this edge down here and over that. Now, you know what you can do if you want, you can actually cut these with a knife. If you need that to go over an edge or you want it to butt up into another rock, then we can just actually use a kitchen knife, real sharp kitchen knife, and cut it. We'll backfill all in here, and our plants will come back there as well. Okay, I think also like that'll end up like that, which looks even better. fantastic where you've placed the first one. You've dug along the front there, you've laid the front of it in. We'll backfill in front of that in a minute with some of the soil that's here. And we'll also do that on top. And that brings to mind that one of the most common questions that asked all the time is, what happens when we have a really big storm? Won't these rocks blow away? And the fact is, once you cover the fronts and the backs with the soil and mulch, then the wind doesn't actually get underneath, and therefore it doesn't move the rocks. I think this looks fantastic. What do you think?
I think it looks great.
Okay, well, remember we got the three other bigger rocks over the side there?
Yeah.
Let's just put and look and see where they will work in this garden. Okay. Well, this is the good thing, isn't it? Hey, how hard is that? You imagine big bobcat coming through here, tearing up all the grass, and you can just pick it up and put it in place like that. Well, placing a rock is always, the Japanese and the Chinese are masters of that. You make it look like it's coming out of the earth and the earth eroded around it, the more natural it looks. So often what we'll do is nestle it right down into the ground, bring some more soil up and around it. Each rock, just like a plant, typically has a better side than another. So what I suggest we do, Deborah, is this is where really everyone's going to see it. So how about we shuffle that rock around a little bit this way, other way. That's a bit more attractive, I think, on the front. So maybe just like that. Okay, and then we nestle that and then backfill here behind it. Now, I love it. We might plant a few more little plants around that, some little mondo grass. We've got two more rocks. How about we grab one of those each? You want to put those there? I'll give you the other one as well, Deborah.
Okay.
That's it. Beautiful. Okay, well, I think I'm just backfill a little bit around it with the soil that's there. About 60 minutes to do that, 1 hour. That wasn't too much of a job, and this is the fun, just washing down and seeing what it looks like at the end. So good job. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Yeah.